who you talking to. Roll up that.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the so-called Silicon Valley and Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with their opponents. A couple of 2-1 teams set to square off, and we're underway here in NFL Week 4. And how about this for a start? This is out of bounds.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
First down. And this will be incomplete. The physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. They'll run for the first time with Raheem Mostert. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Brings up third down and 11.
Little trouble thus far on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 11. James has it, and he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. And he's taken down inside the 30. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Raheem Mostert averaged 5.6 yards per carry last year. That was second in the NFL. So it's safe to say that it paid off that he patterned his work ethic after his hero, Frank Gore, the former 49er. That's a guy who really shows you how to go out and get it done each and every day. Raheem Mostert patterned him and had a breakout season in 2019 with the 49ers.
No gain on the play.
That time on the outside, pretty nice job as a cornerback to shed any would-be blockers and make the tackle.
And think about the praise we're giving him, what his coaches have given, but how about the respect he gets from his teammates to be a complete corner who doesn't just cover receivers, but also tackles ball carriers.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
The last catch did get three, but they're still left needing 7 yards on third down. The shotgun. He'll look to throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against, an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football. But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. Ball carrier. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
Yeah, this is going to be an Eagles first down as he gets it up past the 35. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. On the counter now, it's Sanders. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. On 2nd down now, it's Sanders. Call it a gain of 1 yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
3rd down.
Throwing is Hurts. Hurts fumbles it. We always hear a lot of veterans on the defensive side of the football. They talk about smelling blood in the water, putting pressure on a rookie. They got to him there to force it free, but couldn't recover.
And you mentioned the pressure. Rookie quarterback, you're going to bring more pressure at him at all times because you don't know how he's going to hold up. He was fortunate there. Luck was on his side, able to recover that fumble.
It goes a 42, making a 43-yard punt. 6 on the return, and the Niners will go on offense. 1st and 10. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Now, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on 3rd down.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big 3rd down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
That looks like it's going to be 2 empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
So on 4th down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away. Back deep, Dede Westbrook. And the win last week punted 4 times as this one's away. And here comes Westbrook. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. It'll be a 10-yard return following a punt of 45. And the Eagles will have it, taking over 1st and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
And he stopped immediately there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. They run the counter. It's Sanders. He'll get about 4 here, down to the 43-yard line.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Hurts. Open man completes it to Butler. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down.
A gain of 14. And an Eagle first down.
We're scoreless after one.
Quarter with no score.
Start of the 2nd quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a 1st and 10. On 1st and 10, it's Sanders. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Here's Sanders. And able to get about 3 as he's taken down right at the 20.
He's brought down.
Not a whole lot of room to maneuver there, and I think that's because everyone took care of their responsibilities, filled their gaps, held their place. No place for him to run.
Now look good. Everything got funneled to the nose tackle. They swallowed him up. Third down, they'll run it with Sanders. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders, his first touchdown on the year, as his guys are on the board first here tonight. So they went to the ground game on 3rd, hoping to pick up the 1st. They also picked up a touchdown.
Offensive linemen so used in this situation to having to pass block. All right, you're looking at what it is, 3rd down. They don't care that it's 3rd and whatever. They figure they're going to throw the ball. And when you call a running play, I think you energize them. I think you juice them up because I haven't met offensive linemen yet that likes to pass block more than they like to run block. And they opened up some nice holes there for him, and he took it to the house.
25-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. 2 drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10.
Undercut.
Now back to throw. Taking a shot for Samuel. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Debo Samuel was the intended receiver. And it's 2nd down.
Looks like they went for the combo play there. Nice ample gain on the ground on the previous play. Going for the big shot on that one, unsuccessfully.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10.
I want 3.
running back. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
As a linebacker, you're taught to stay just slightly behind the ball carrier just in case he makes a cutback. But when you find the gap, shoot it. And he found it all right, took it straight into the backfield, and made the tackle for a loss.
The Niners on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And that is intercepted by the Pro Bowl corner, Darius Slay. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because 2 interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. That one whistled against a big right tackle.
You'd think being able to fire out and block, it'd be a lot easier to not commit a holding penalty, but it's tough to keep those guys right in front, isn't it?
From the gun, it's Hurts. Flush to his right. He's going to take off with it. Oh, he's got some breathing room. That's on Lane Johnson, the former top 5 pick. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Hurts. If they didn't have that penalty a moment ago, it'd be a first down. Still a nice 13-yard pickup.
You go back to the second round of the draft, and when Jalen Hurts' name was called, a lot of Philadelphia fans weren't extremely happy about it. But when you see his ability, he can be mobile and make plays out of the pocket, but he's got a much better arm and much more accurate than what people think. Remember, he was raised by his father in the game of football. His dad was his high school coach. This kid is a true gym rat, and he's going to get better every time out.
And the Niners get there and bring him down. And Nick Bosa is so quick on the outside, he gets in there to bring him down.
I couldn't quite hear, but I could imagine it was a big lookout to the quarterback as Nick Bosa got to him yet again for another sack. The 2019 Defensive Rookie of the Year, he continues to make an impact now, and I expect that for seasons to come. Not only is he a great player himself, because of his work, because of his excellent play, he makes everyone else in that defensive line that much better too.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Able to pick up a dozen yards, but they needed more. Fourth down.
Well, it's not going to be a first down, but that's a nice job of picking up yardage on third and long. Sometimes you just have to take what the defense gives you. And in this case, it wasn't enough to pick up the first down.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And 2 picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw 4 or 5 picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Pick it up.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Second and 14. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Well, Fletcher Cox, he's been doing this for a lot of years, and another sack to his ledger there. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. That's caught by his running back, Raheem Mostert. And he will lose yardage here back to his own 6. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to make it 4th down. Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this one goes sailing out of bounds. Where did it cross? Well, they're going to say on this side of midfield. 48-yard line. But 1st down, Hurts. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Rookie quarterback, rookie running back. They team up there to pick up the first. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Here's Hurts to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Sanders. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. Going to throw right side here, complete. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a 2nd and long. A little risky there when you roll out of that pocket right like he did. You complete the pass, but you don't get anything out of it.
But how many times have we seen when a quarterback exits out of the pocket, doesn't matter if they go left or right, the defense loses its leverage, right? There's a little chaos back there. And receivers come open. Great discipline on that play. They didn't let that happen and held it to no gain.
5 yards. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
Is 3rd down.
Back to throw again. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles. All passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
On 1st and 10, it's Hurts. Steps away to his left. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Eagles add on to their lead. Showed some of his improv skills there, getting flushed out of the pocket but still able to make the throw for the score.
So that means he's not a method actor?
No.
Because with the improv means break character when you need to. And in the NFL, when you have those guys chasing you, sometimes you have to break character in a big way. But I love the fact that he stayed downfield, kept his eyes up, and made the play. How many rookies do that well?
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26.
49 to Mike. Watch 49. Ricky.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. He finds an opening past the 40. And all the way down inside the 25 before he's out of bounds. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. They'll drop the throw. Gets this one to Juszczyk. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
He's at the 14-yard line. A gain of 9. Brings up second and 1.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field.
31-yard attempt.
And in his 15th season, he's able to get this one to go. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. And how about this right out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. For Sanders, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
First down, Eagles.
They'll run. It's Sanders. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. He'll look to throw, and a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. A little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
They'll run on first down. Sanders. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
The ball carrier.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A great effort there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And a little dangerous there, almost a penalty, but it does get into the end zone before going over the sideline for a touchback. They run the counter now on first down. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
He's taken down at the
first play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Watch twitch. And a give this time to the tailback. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be 2nd and very short.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on 2nd and less than a yard. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A gain of just 1 yard, but it's a first down.
2nd and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on 3rd down and pick up the 1st down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are. Stay with who you know. And go get the 1st down. That's exactly what they did.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up 2nd down.
George Kittle is easily one of the elite tight ends in the NFL. Back-to-back seasons of 88 and 85 catches. We just saw another one right there. Anytime he lines up on the field, you better treat him as a primary receiver and make sure you have a 2nd guy in the vicinity to try and cover him.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to take this close to the 1st down marker as he stopped at the Eagles 38. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Now before the 2nd down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn 1 here in this 3rd quarter. Second and 10 here as we roll along in quarter number 3 from Santa Clara. And for a 3rd time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way? Threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later.
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning, threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Now Sanders. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Another run here with Sanders. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield.
He's across midfield.
Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. On first down. It's Sanders, and he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. Going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That third down conversion good for 23. They'll run on first down. It's Sanders. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, 2nd and 2.
8 yards on the pickup brings up 2nd and 2 at the 17 yard line.
Another run with Sanders. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Sanders, and he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders taking it in, and the Eagles able to push further out in front. He's got the hat trick, 3 touchdowns now.
Did you throw yours? Did you throw yours out there?
I didn't have mine. You've got yours. You've got one of those Abe Lincoln hats.
Yeah, and that stovepipe is going right out there for a nose for the end zone. Third time today. I think he deserves a tip of the cap.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Brings up 2nd and 12 at the 23-yard line.
Second.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12.
Winds up and lets it go for Samuel.
And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think part of their plan was to hit them over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
The Niners on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third down and 12.
Let's get off the field. Let's get off the field. 49, guys. Mike, 49.
Yeah, that's right.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. That one caught by Ross Dwelly. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down, San Francisco, to pick up 14 yards. They'll look to throw. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. They'll contain him to just 4, second down. That's just his second catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game, and they've done a great job of doing that.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
The Niners on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. Open man is IU complete. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. But no reason not to try it there. And they do indeed convert on 4th. On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Brandon Graham applied the heat off the edge. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hadn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense, I got it.
You see what I did there?
Yeah. He needs better protection, that's for sure. The second down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration to body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Looking to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
I have a few questions about that throw because, to me, there just wasn't a lot there. I thought he tried to do a little bit too much, almost tried to will a receiver open when there was no chance he was going to be. Nice job by the linebacker being all over that one and knocking it away.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like.
Fire!
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
We've got a lopsided game here. I don't know, Charles, what does the handbook say that we discuss when we've got a game like this in the fourth quarter?
Hold on a second. Let me thumb to the proper page on that. Know what it says?
What?
Let's discuss how we got here. This is a dominant performance. Where they took control of this game, how they managed to keep control of this game, and then we go ahead and think about how we're going to leave here and get to the airport. In a lopsided blowout, the roads are usually open.
Check. Lucky.
On first down, Sanders. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
Brought him down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. They'll go again with Sanders. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 11 yards there, first down.
At carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Now, first down carry by Sanders, well-defensed as they'll hold him to just a couple. Second down coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Shotgun snap, and then the give to Sanders. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That one good for 26 and a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Throwing is Hurts. And this is caught at the 8. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
Philadelphia.
Check, watch 54. Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved. That false start, costly. Moves them back to the 9 now, first and goal. That one looks like he'll throw here. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. They get Lane Johnson, the number 4 pick back in 2013. A terrible spot for a holding call as he'll try again, but now from further back on first and goal. Hurts. And he fires one incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. Here's second and goal. A throw left side complete to his receiver, Westbrook. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. A 10-yard completion, but still now facing third and goal.
Mike 54. 19 tight. I can't believe they even let you play.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
Taken in the end zone.
And we see James, he will not return it, and they'll bring it out to the 25.
They're on 25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. That's complete to Mostert out of the backfield.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's James.
The pass.
Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go.
The 44-yard line.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Flushed out right. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
First down with Hurts. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 3-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. So it's a victory here for the Philadelphia Eagles. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for Philadelphia, they're on a nice early roll as they move to 3-1 with a win here. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the Pittsburgh Steelers. Meanwhile, for the 49ers, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2. And they will be at home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm...